Hey guys, today I want to help you become a pro motorbike stunter by showing you all tricks and stunting techniques that are possible in GTA 5. And because this video is pretty long actually, I provided you guys with chapters of the different tricks so you can navigate through the video very easily. And now, let's begin with some basics first. We are starting very easy and simple with the motorbike wheelie trick. Just pull your stick down and hold it there to get a wheelie. You can also turn while doing a wheelie, by the way. Certain motorbikes can of course do higher wheelies than others. I recommend you guys using the typical stunting bikes, the Bati 801, Ruffian, Gargoyle or Hakushu for it. Trick number 2 is the bike stoppy. For this one, all you have to do is lean forward on your bike and hold your brakes at the same time. The more speed you have, the longer your stoppy can be, of course. 180s, 360s, 720s or even 1080s are explained very fast again. Just lean either to the left or right side to turn your bike. For a 180 or 360, you don't need very far jumps, of course. If you wanna pull off a 720 or 1080 though, you really need a lot of airtime. Not easy, but very epic in the end. Next, I wanna show you how to do backflips and front flips. The backflip is a bit easier to do in most cases because it can be pulled off faster. All you have to do is lean back in midair. But if you wanna do your backflip as fast as possible, you can just stop leaning backwards at about the half of the backflip. And the rest of the backflip is then done automatically for you. Pretty cool trick. Sadly, this method doesn't work for the front flip. In order to pull that off, you have to keep leaning forwards instead of backwards, of course. So for front flips, you will always need more airtime to be able to pull them off. Another pretty cool trick is the backwards ride. Normally, it isn't possible to drive backwards very fast with your motorcycle, of course, but with this trick, it actually works. Just get a normal jump first and then turn your bike 180 degrees to land backwards on the ground again. If you wanna get a little speed boost, land with your back wheel to use the so-called ground climb technique, which I will explain more detailed again later in this tutorial. Then, just don't do anything and let your bike ride by itself. You can actually go very far like this and for example do cool stunts with this method. But not only can you ride backwards, but also sideways at certain spots. That's the so-called side ride technique. For this one you just have to land on certain parts of the grounds in exactly this position and just keep accelerating. Indeed unrealistic, but kinda cool anyway. Just like with BMXs, it is also possible to grind with motorbikes, of course, and there are actually 3 different types of grinds. For the normal grind, you just have to land sideways on a rail and balance your bike out a little bit to stay in the grind. For a so-called handlebar grind, you have to land in exactly this weird position. Here you have to balance your bike out by rotating your left analog stick, as you can see on the live controller. If you wanna do this trick, by the way, I would recommend using the Faggio, Sanchez or Enduro bike. Super funny one. And for the so-called back grind, you have to land in the exact opposite position. This one is only possible with the thrust, of course, when you have added the pockets to it. Also, you can grind like this with your pockets. Another really cool trick is the so-called hipster slide, which is very similar to the BMX hipster slide. All you have to do is search for a bump, turn your bike either to the left or right side and land in this position. In order to balance your bike out, you have to rotate your stick once again. Here it is also possible to adjust your slide height, so you can either do a low or high hipster slide depending on your needs. So those were already all basic tricks that you can do on a motorbike. And now let's continue with some important facts and techniques for stunting. For stunting, you want to know how to maximize your speed on a motorbike, of course. And in GTA 5, this is possible by doing high wheelies on your bike. Here you can see that I'm actually going way faster with wheelies than without. Another very interesting GTA logic. The best stunting bikes with the highest wheelies and the best maximum speed are the Bati 801, Hakushu, Ruffian and Gargoyle, by the way. If you want to get even more speed on your motorbike, you have to know a very advanced trick actually many people don't know about. If you are driving over certain parts of the road in GTA 5, mainly curbs, your wheelies are getting higher for like a second. But this can actually give you nice speed boosts, and many stunt spots aren't even possible without using this technique. Very important to know. Now let's talk a little bit about bumps in GTA 5. There is actually a simple rule which works in 95% of all cases. For very tall bumps, you have to use stunting bikes like the Hakushu or BF400 because those can do higher wheelies in general. For short bumps, you can use bikes like the Barty 801 or Gargoyle. In order to bump somewhere, you of course have to do a high enough wheelie, pretty easy. But what many people don't know actually is this. If you are doing a very late wheelie before the bump, you mainly get a lot of distance instead of height. And the other way around, if you are doing a very early wheelie before bumping, you can get a lot of height mainly. That's of course very important to know depending on the stunt you want to hit. Sometimes you want to maximize your distance, but sometimes just your height. So after you have bumped or ramped off somewhere, you want to know how to reach the maximum distance of course. And for that, you have to know the gliding technique in GTA 5. There are actually three different types of glides, the so-called speed glide, the balance glide, and the brake glide. You need a so-called speed glide, especially for stunt spots where you want to use multiple bumps. To get it, you have to hold your front tire above your back tire. To stay in this position, you have to rotate your stick very fast again. And as the name of this glide already tells you, it makes sure that you can keep as much speed as possible. So for example, if you go off a bump and then want to get a double bump somewhere to prepare another big jump, the speed glide is exactly what you need. By doing a speed glide, you also reduce your height of course, and this minimizes your chance to fall off your bike. Very useful. The so-called balance glide is mainly used for single jumps where you want to maximize your distance. Here you have to hold your front tire just slightly above your back tire, sometimes also completely parallel to the ground, and hold the position by rotating your stick. This gliding position makes sure that you really get the furthest jump possible. If you have already maximized your speed with the techniques that I showed you before, like wheelieing and driving over curbs, you should be able to glide really far now. But the so-called brake glide is also super useful actually and shouldn't stay unexplained too. To achieve it, move your front tire under your back tire and hold the position by rotating your stick. This gliding position will let you lose speed and height at the same time. The reason why you should use it instead of just releasing your glide completely is very simple. By doing a brake glide, you can precisely adjust your height and speed depending on exactly how much you move your front tire under your back tire. If you would just release your glide completely, there is almost no way to control your height and speed anymore. And at the same time, you minimize the chance of falling off your bike by doing a controlled brake glide. Super useful technique again, and you should really master every single gliding position if you want to hit the best possible motorbike stunts. And because gliding is such an important stunting technique in GTA 5, I provided you guys with a race link in the description where you can practice your gliding skills too. The race I provided you is the so-called infinite glide glitch in GTA 5. By going off Mount Chiliad, using a speed glide first and then going off this hill with mainly a balanced and a speed glide again, you can actually glide infinitely if you did everything right. Especially because you have so much airtime here, it is the best spot to practice your gliding skills in my opinion. And of course the infinite glide is a very impressive technique which makes everyone think that you are a modder. If you are bored of the normal glide at some point, you can also try to do a backwards glide. With this one you sadly can't get as much distance as with the normal glide, but you can still go way further than without a glide. In order to do it, you have to turn your bike by 180 degrees and then go into this position. And just as always, hold that position by rotating your stick. Sadly, it is very hard to turn while being in this position, but it isn't impossible too. Now let's take a look at some more advanced GTA 5 motorbike tricks and techniques, which are very helpful for landings especially, starting with the so-called wall climb. In order to do a wall climb, pretty much all you have to do is hit a wall with your front tire first, hold your brakes, and then lean forward on your bike. As you can see, this gives you a massive boost upwards and lets you land incredible stunts. Sadly though, the wall climb is actually more powerful the more frames per second you have in GTA 5. This means that console players who are limited to 30 or 60 FPS will always have less effective wall climbs than PC players who can play up to 188 FPS. But even with 30 or 60 FPS, wall climbing is still possible and very useful for certain stunts, believe me guys. A more advanced wall climb technique is the so-called radio wall climb. That's a cool technique that has been found recently actually and is only possible if you are playing GTA 5 in story mode or director mode. Cause what you have to do here is go in the radio selection menu of GTA 5 just before doing a normal wall climb. Hit the wall with your front tire first, hold your brakes, lean forward, and now get an even higher boost upwards. This technique is super powerful actually and makes it possible for you to hit insane stunts, super crazy. And another super crazy wall climb technique, which is only possible with very high FPS, is the Faggio Sport wall climb glitch. For some reason, if you use the Faggio Sport bike and do a normal wall climb starting from the ground, you can get a massive boost upwards and land on top of huge buildings like the IAA or FIB for example. If you thought that GTA 5 is realistic up to this point, I guess you don't think so anymore now. Now there is only one more wall climb technique which can't be used for landings directly, but it can help you reach even further distances with your bike, and that's the so-called ground climb. This technique really requires you to have a lot of FPS, so I wouldn't recommend console players trying it out. But to all PC players, listen carefully now. For the ground climb, you have to hit the ground with your front tire first, but then don't activate your brakes, otherwise you would also slow down, and lean a bit forward on your bike. If you did everything right and your FPS are also really high, you can now get a very nice speed boost and glide even further than before. Crazy technique. But now back to the landing techniques in GTA 5. In case you can't land a stunt with a wall climb, for example because you're not coming towards the landing target from the bottom, I now wanna show you some helpful techniques how to land precision stunts in GTA 5. So what I do in most cases is that I hold my brakes right before the landing and then just hit the edge of the landing target with my front tire first. This makes sure that you can land very precisely on spot. But here you also have to make sure that you lean back enough. Cause if you don't, especially if you have a lot of speed, you will just bump away from the landing target. But also if you lean back too much, you will just fall down. So there's actually one specific position which you need to be able to land on spot, and that's of course very hard to get. And this technique is seriously humanly impossible to master, at least for a 100% success rate. Next I wanna show you guys how to wall ride in GTA 5. And yes, wall riding is actually something different than wall climbing. For a wall ride you should use one of the two typical wall ride bikes, the Sanchez or Enduro. So pretty much all you have to do for a wall ride is turn your bike parallel towards the wall you wanna ride. Then hit the wall with your back tire first. After that, just balance your bike out and keep riding on the wall. You just have to be careful not to turn too much at once. If you wanna go up or down the wall, it is almost always better to do it slowly. But of course, if you wanna jump out of the wall ride to get the maximum distance afterwards, stay low at first and then instantly ride up the wall. Super impressive technique, but not as easy as it looks, believe me guys. So those were actually all possible motorbike tricks already that you can do in GTA 5. But now, because many people keep asking me that, I wanna show you how to stunt in the most efficient way, starting with the PC version of GTA 5. In most cases, I go to the director mode in GTA 5 together with some mod menus that I've installed. If you wanna know how to get those mods too, I will link you my modding tutorial video in the info card right now. The advantage of director mode is that it automatically increases your frames per second. You can disable all pedestrians, traffic, and turn on invincibility in the director mode menu, which is of course awesome to hit your stunts without any distractions. Then if I want to stunt with anti-fall, which means that I'm not able to fall off my bike no matter what I do, I go to my mod menu, the simple trainer, and activate this option called bike seatbelt. For many stunt spots that's actually a big help, for others not really. And right now I'm just going to a certain location where I want to hit a stunt and set a respawn point at the start of the run up with the so-called set point mod. After every single attempt, all I have to do is press one certain key on my keyboard and boom, instantly respawn again. Stunting like this is the most fun and convenient way in my opinion. But for people who can't install mods because they aren't playing on PC, there's also another way how to stunt. By going to the creator in GTA 5 Online and creating a land race for your stunts, you can stunt almost as well. In order to create a land race, enter your race title and description, make your race a point-to-point race, choose the vehicle you wanna stunt with, turn off traffic, and then place a starting checkpoint at the beginning of your run-up. The second checkpoint must be at least 1 kilometer away and can be anywhere you want. After you have done that, test the race and drive to the finish line. Now you can publish that race already, and all you have to do now is open it up in your own created jobs in GTA 5 Online. Once you have started it, you can now try to hit your stunt, and every time you wanna respawn, just hold the Y button on a Xbox controller or the triangle button on your PlayStation controller. The only disadvantage compared to the director mode is that you automatically have anti-fall in those races, and you can only deactivate traffic but not pedestrians. But still, that's a lot better than stunting in free mode where you have to drive back to the starting points manually over and over again, isn't it guys? So yeah guys, that was actually already everything about motorbike stunting in GTA 5. If this video was helpful for you, don't forget to drop a like on it and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you wanna practice all of those techniques with specific motorbike stunt spots, then don't forget to check out my top 50 motorbike stunt spots video right now. And I'm gonna see you soon again guys, until then have a great time and bye!